Yeah, but the immediate future of this programme, about the next hour, is devoted to the final headliner of the week, weekend even. And they are celebrating their 50th anniversary here on the Pyramid stage. So you know all about them anyway, but as a little reminder, here is the story of The Who.
The only way I was ever going to fit into society and have a role was via this guitar. People try to put us to
death. Talking about my dream. The Who? It's a question few people need to ask of tonight's Pyramid Stage headliners. Some may try to put them down, but for over 50 years now, they've been rocking my generation and yours with their maximum R&B sound and have sold over 100 million records along the way. Emerging out of West London in the early 60s, The Who quickly became mod icons with a string of top 10 hits including I'm a Boy, Substitute and I Can See for Miles. The band's live shows became notorious for their destructive raw power and, along with the Beatles and the Stones, were at the vanguard of the mid-60s British invasion of the US. Featuring Daltrey's belting vocals, Moon's wild drumming, Entwistle's powerhouse bass lines and Townsend's furious licks, individually they were unrivaled, but together they were arguably the perfect rock band. The release of pioneering rock opera Tommy in 1969 was greeted with rapturous critical acclaim.
I'm today's powerful young man, I'm today's successful young man. Sure plays a
mean and, along with an era-defining appearance at Woodstock, it helped cement their reputation as rock and roll icons. The 70s saw huge success and further landmark albums, including Live at Leeds, Who's Next, and a celebration of their mod roots with Quadrophenia. The tragic death of Keith Moon in 1978 contributed to a growing sense of disillusionment within the band, and the wheels eventually came off The Who tour bus in 1982.
I just don't want to perform with The Who anymore.
Why?
We've just reached the end.
But in spite of creative and personal tensions, the band were tempted back to the stage throughout the 80s and 90s, until John Entwistle's untimely death in 2002. And then there were two. The Who's surviving members Roger Daltrey and Pete Townsend ploughed on, and headlining at Glastonbury back in 2007 proved the band's pioneering spirit was as raw and relevant as ever. Now, as they hit their half century and return to the Pyramid stage, a whole new generation of fans out here in the field are set to see and feel that The Who are still The Who.
Simple job to do tonight, which is to send you home happy, maybe a bit deaf. Here we go.
Thank you.
This one's for Paul Weller, and you, of course. Lily, oh Lily, Lily, oh Lily.
Thank you.
Thank you.
to very quickly introduce this band. Over there on guitar and vocals is my brother, Simon Townsend. Behind him on keyboards, John Corey. On bass, Pino Palladino. The guy in the hat is our music director. Ha ha ha. We do need one though, his name's Frank Sands. Over here on keyboards and backing vocals, Lauren Gold. And on drums behind the plastic, Zach Starkey. This could have been better, but it's as good as it can be. It would be great if to have done a sound check and got our sound sorted out before we came out and hit you with all this shit. But we're gonna send you home now with a rebellious, oh yay, who's the biggest fucking rock star in the world? That must be Elvis Presley. Anyway. Here we go.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
you, Glastonbury.
There you go, The Who, the closing headliner on the Pyramid Stage at Glastonbury 2015. I think emphatically done the job there.
They did, they were well happy with that.